Moerdenaar's Neck has a very unusual profile in that the road rises and falls through a series of false summits over its full length of 12.3 kilometers. The road had recently been refurbished at the time of filming in April 2017 and was in an excellent condition. As usual, hazards in this part of the Eastern Cape include pedestrians, livestock, as well as slow-moving vehicles. It's also not advisable to traverse this pass at night or in bad weather, but if this is unavoidable, reduce your speed to below the posted speed restrictions and be prepared to brake suddenly at a moment's notice. The pass was undoubtedly named after a homicide in the area, but when this occurred cannot be established. The pass is located on the R56, one of the main trunk routes in the area, and connects McClear in the south with Mount Fletcher in the north. We filmed this pass from north to south. The starting point is where the R56 crosses a bridge over the Luzi River. Just after the bridge, there's a gravel road leading off to the right. This is the road which will take you through the Luzi Poort, up the Pitseng Pass, and ultimately over Noordeer's Neck to Rhodes. It forms a convenient shortcut from this point to the small village in that it is much shorter than the route via McClear and is considerably more scenic. The road curves to the right, then climbs slowly towards the large mountain directly ahead of you. A long straight of 1.1 kilometer splits into a double lane about halfway along this section, then changes back to a single lane as the road enters a gentle S-bend, first turning right and then left. The gradient then flattens out and straightens out for another 1.3 kilometers as the road undulates gently between some rural houses scattered about on either side. The gradient kicks up once more as the straight comes to an end and the road curves to the right. This leads into a gradual left-hand curve, then into a shallow dip, followed by another left-hand bend. Safety railings protect you from the drop-off on the left, and a steep cutting is evident on the right-hand side. The road curves back to the right through a long corner of 120 degrees, the gravel cuttings giving way to a stepped stone-packed retaining wall. A double lane is once again presented as the road climbs through a short straight to the first of the false summits along the pass. The next section is by far the most interesting and scenic part of this road. The pass remains flat for a short straight of 650 meters, then curves to the right through a fairly tight corner of 90 degrees and into a short descent. This leads into an S-bend with positive banking on both corners, the road first turning left and then back to the right. The population of Mount Fletcher is largely constituted by the rural community, with land outside the town still controlled by traditional leaders. There are different tribes who constitute the population. These include the Amashlubi, who were the original inhabitants of the area, as well as the Basutu, Batembu and Baputi. The town infrastructure is still underdeveloped, with water shortages a major challenge, especially to those living outside the town, as they have to fetch water at a communal tap or borehole. The road starts to ascend very gently once more through a shallow right-hand curve between some very steep cuttings which block the view on either side. It then descends again slowly through a series of corners, leading up to another low point. Please heed the double barrier line throughout this section. Because of the corners and the cuttings, it's quite difficult to see oncoming traffic, and you'll not have much time to avoid a collision if you attempt to pass other slow-moving vehicles. Here the road stretches out ahead of you in a long straight of exactly 1 kilometer before the next gentle right-hand bend is encountered. The climb continues through a shallow left-hand corner, then follows a fairly straight path up towards the low neck on the skyline. Most internet sources state that Mount Fletcher is named after the Reverend John William Fletcher, founder of the first mission established in the area by British Methodists in 1882. This person did in fact exist, but the Reverend Fletcher never travelled to South Africa and he died in 1785, so it's impossible that he founded a mission station in the Eastern Cape almost 100 years after his death. The village which becomes visible at the neck has the unusual name of Chevy Chase. Be sure to watch part 2 of the Moerdenaar's Neck series.